Hey guys, welcome to the gallery. Thought I was going to do a voiceover within stories, but I guess I decided not to. Just gonna... Oh, this is starting out well, isn't it? So how's everyone today? It's Tuesday, October, I don't know what day it is today. Is it the 27th? I think it's the 27th. And it's a cloudy day. It looks like it's going to rain today. So it's a perfect day to do some diamond painting. I'm almost finished with this one. I got this section left to do. And then there's this section. So I'm working on the stars right now. Oops, what the hell? Sorry. Hope children aren't watching this. If you're under 18, please leave the channel. Appreciate you watching, but I might say something. I don't normally, but I don't want to swear and get in trouble with your parents, so. I don't know what to talk about today. Came on here thinking I was going to chat about something specifically. This painting is from Craft Pack Canada, and if you watched my video unboxing this, there is a link there. It is a panda from the Toronto Zoo. If you're new here, I am Canadian. And so this particular company caught my eye. I found out about this company through Facebook, one of the Facebook diamond painting groups I belong to. So, I asked about it, and I asked if they would like to send me a diamond painting to get the word out and let people know about their company. They are new, so they don't have a lot of paintings right now, but they will be getting more soon. And this is... I liked this one, and there's another one that has two Muskoka chairs looking out over the lake, and that attracted me as well, but because of my love for pandas, I chose this one. So... What are you guys working on? What whips are you guys working on? Is anyone working on Christmas ones? I have a bit of a treat coming. I'm not going to tell you what it's about. It's going to be an unboxing of some sort. Probably within the next 2 weeks, hopefully. I'm not going to tell you what it is. Like I said, it's going to be a surprise. So if you're subscribed and if... That's great. Turn on your notification bell so it will notify you when I upload that particular video. And if you're not subscribed and you're intrigued by what I'm going to show on this channel, please hit the subscribe button and consider waiting around And I hope if you subscribe, you stay. Because I do whips and I do unboxings. And I am approaching the 100 subscriber marker. I never thought I would say that. YouTube is a huge platform, a huge social media platform. And 100 subscribers is just a blip. But to someone like me and the niche that I belong to, it's a lot getting started. I started this channel in July on my birthday, July 20th, so that I will remember when my anniversary of putting up my videos is. And we're now at the end of October, and I have almost 100 subscribers. So that's July, August, September. It's 4 months. It was a slow start. I thought many times of shutting down this channel because no one was finding me. And now it seems that I get subscribers and I say, "Where did you find me?" And they said, "I searched." But when I search, like say I log out of my YouTube account, when I search, I don't find myself. I'm probably at the very bottom because there's so many people that have bigger channels than I do when it comes to diamond painting. But I am very grateful if you found me that way. Like if you searched diamond paintings and you found me, I'm really grateful. That's awesome. Doesn't happen for me. I don't know why. Maybe because I'm the YouTube creator. But like I said, I've been signing out of my account so I could see what you see when you search on YouTube. And I don't see my account. Probably at the bottom. And I really don't have that kind of patience to go all the way down there to look. But thank you if you're here because you searched. That's awesome. And so I'm going to do this in silence. And I will probably do a quick story from my, so this is going to be a little whip and chat and also whip and stories. I'll tell you a couple of stories from my Chicken Soup for the Soul book that I have been reading. I got a few people interested in that. So I can do that. Oops. I don't like when my drills do this, that they stick to each other like this. So here's a good opportunity. When you get drills that stick to each other, just get, you have your green tray and you get another green tray. Hear that cracking? It's supposed to separate them. So if you're new and you get drills that stick to each other, don't worry. You could also use a one of those dryer sheets. That will separate them. You put them inside with your drills in the bags or in a container. Okay, so I got a few more. And this little piece there, that is trash. You don't put, that's not, that's like trashy drill. So I'm going to put it in with my trash. So you just shake it again. Yeah, so I'm excited about this video that I'm about to post in the next 2 weeks. Hopefully it works out. Some of these drills are attached to each other somehow. I have some other colored drills, but since I know which one I'm working with, I don't touch the other colored drills. A partial. Ooh, it's another trashy.